Well, today, I'll see if I can actually accomplish anything. Lately, my enthusiasm is totally overshadowed by my lack of ambition. Especially when the sun starts to shine, and it's starting to shine. So, we have a wonderful D28 Martin here. We're hoping I can steam up that little cadernt in it. Which certainly won't make it worse. Let's just check the condition now before I do anything and see where we're at with it. I did have a peek at the neck. The frets are in good shape. They're not at all dented and munched. Just see what the heck's going on with this. I thought the neck was too straight, and I was absolutely right. It's very, very straight. So before we even put the new strings on it, let's release the truss rod a little bit and see what happens. Martin really loved to hide that way in there. So a little lefty loosey. Wow, this is really tight. Try and find it again. Come on, you can do it, Davey. It's in there. I know it is. I had it. Oh, I hate this. Drives me nuts. Well, let's try that. Tune it back up. Close enough for rock and roll. So the problem with this now is that I didn't like the string height before. Now that I've released this a bit, I'll stop there. That's maybe, yeah, I should probably release it a little bit more. Just a titch. It'll take me longer to find it than it will to do it. Oh, you're in there. Gotcha. Okay, we're gonna stop there. See what happened. Okay, we'll let that just settle in a little bit. That seems fantastic. What's the string height doing now? Surprise, surprise. What would we like to see? I don't like to see it more than 64s. They'll sell these to you sitting at around 7 and call it good. Right now we are sitting at 8 64s, which we don't like at all, which means I want to take a 1 2 at least. 2 64s, that's a 32. Means I gotta take a 16th off the saddle. Do I have enough to do that? I think so. Looks like it. So we should be okay. Let's play steam with the dent over here, see if we can make it better. So I got my big old ugly soldering thing that I use to remove frets. Alright, as long as you see steam, you're fine. See what happened here. Did I bring it up at all? A little bit. It's coming. The other thing is this takes patience too, right? It's just like instant results are not necessarily instant. Once again, just make sure that's good and wet. When you see the steam blow out of the side of the cloth, you know you're really getting it. It's starting to come up. I don't know. It's about the same to me. But I gave it a try. What can I say? Let's get the strings off it. And what I will do is I will set the neck straight with no string tension. And then we will take the bridge saddle down to what I figured, what I ciphered. And then put the new strings on it. Shine up the frets, all that good stuff. Someone was asking or commenting about this is 4 thou. So my previous truss rod adjustment was probably successful because now with no string tension, it's all good and straight. Okay, shaving down the bridge saddle, away we go. Okay, here I go again. Oh yeah, you remember I said my eyes are getting bad? Yeah, oh yeah, they're bad. I had eye exam this week. And my prescription has changed. And also, not very happy about this at all. Acute angle closure, aka glaucoma. But hey, I got the I don't have the one that gradually builds up over time. The one they figure I have is called acute, which means it's kind of scary because I got to go see another guy. If the angle in my eye closes, it could close very suddenly and within a very brief period of time, I could lose like half my vision. So, we gotta go get that looked at. That'll be glorious. Anyway, while I still have eyes, let's shave this down.
This little belt sander guy is probably the best $60 I ever spent. But what I did is I modified the decks so that I can get tighter, because there's like a huge, if you saw under there, you'd see it's a huge gap. And I did that on both decks so I can get as close as possible.
Today's string choice will be exactly what they say to put on it. Imagine that. Okay, we're all tuned up. New strings. Let's revisit that neck relief thing and see where we're at, because the strings have been off it. I wouldn't touch that right now, because I'd let this guitar sit for a while and we're going to check everything again. Well, let's see what happens with the string heights after I lowered the bridge saddle. And just to be clear, taking the bridge saddle down on your Martin guitar is not a warranty voiding thing. It's just a part. Right? So now we're sitting just snugly, right? Sort of in between 5 and 6/64. And same thing on the treble side. But I will point something out. I'm going to change the camera angle and show you this.
Back to what I was saying about taking down the bridge saddle. I wouldn't take that down anymore. We're pretty much at the end of it. But back to acoustic guitars. This always sinks. This always rises up. It doesn't really matter how much you spend. Unless you buy like a super jumbo workhorse Guild or a big fat Gibson. And, you know, I'm just sort of looking at the belly on this. And, yeah, it's raised up. So, if the guitar is finished doing that and the string action stays where it is, it's going to be a beautiful thing from here on out. But if the guitar continues to change, this would be a candidate to have to go back to Martin to have the neck angle redone. Anyway, folks, thanks for hanging out. Martin D28, good to go. Like I said, let it sit.
check it all again, but it should be good. Trim the strings off, the ends, and go have a sandwich.
All the links to stuff are below if you want to get a sticker or whatever, or become a patron. And special thanks and shout out to all my patrons for helping me keep this going, and my subscribers, and, you know, the Facebook group, well, that sort of spins its own wheels. Twitter me if you like, and most of all, be good to each other, folks. Till next time, take care and cheers.